Still in the news, the Ministry of Health is in need of an estimated 1.3 trillion shillings to continue with the implementation of the COVID-19 resurgence plan. This was revealed during the launch of the National Coronavirus Disease Resurgence Plan. We have the report.
In the newly launched National COVID-19 Resurgence Plan, June 2021 to June 2022, the Ministry of Health revealed its plans to strengthen a number of infection prevention and control strategies. Priority will be given to capacity building of health workers, support triage, screening and establishment of isolation areas at health facilities, improvement on logistics of health facilities, enhanced risk communication and community engagements, among other interventions. The Ministry revealed that they need a whooping 1.3 trillion shillings to implement the plan.
The pillar of coordination came up with about 3.3 million, surveillance 16.7, laboratory 22, case management 25, risk communication 19, community engagement 1.7. The other pillar of innovation 19. Logistics, continuity of essential services, 31 million. Vaccination, 710. Now, this 710 does not include vaccine procurement.
First response plan was heavily supported. It was estimated at $600 million. Partners mobilized up to $77.5 million, which was 35%. And government mobilized heavily. I think we fell short of about 10%.
The outgoing Minister of Health, Dr. Jane Ruth Acheng, says that this is half of what they used in the first wave of the pandemic outbreak. The good news, however, half of this money has already been sourced.
Presented today is $359 million. Many will ask, why is it less than the first? Because infrastructure has been put in place, systems have been put in place, and the systems are moving. What we need is now to strengthen those systems. And one of the issues that needs to be really emphasized at any one time is the aspect of human resources. We cannot do without human resources.
Acheng further revealed that the current wave of COVID-19 infections has already overwhelmed the health systems and a number of health workers have been fatigued, which is even worsened by the poor remuneration of these health workers.
When an emergency goes on for so long, then the health workers get really fatigued. And more so with this resurgence, where the numbers are growing exponentially every day. Many of you will recall that the highest number of cases we got in the first wave was 700. Already we have surpassed that mark within only 3 weeks, and the hospitals are getting full so fast.
Plans are, however, underway to pay these health workers, she says. Even those whose contracts had expired will be re-recruited to provide adequate human resource at the COVID-19 response facility, Mulago National Referral Hospital, and other public health facilities.
There are over 476 people who were contracted, or health workers who were contracted, to manage the COVID pandemic and deployed in several areas all over the country. And also their contracts came to an end, but the strategic committee in the Ministry of Health sat down and resolved that the contracts of these 476 officers should be immediately renewed, and that they must be paid the allowances.
As of yesterday, Uganda's confirmed cumulative cases stood at 49,759, while 363 died and 47,760 had recovered, but 522 are still in hospital undergoing treatment. This story was compiled by Rachel Nachiwala for the news in Kampala.